Welcome to everyone. Urban changes during the British period. So what is the meaning? Urban means city. So normal village became the city during the British period. We are learning in this lesson during the British period how village changed to the city. One of the good example is Chennai. Chennai is most populous district in our Tamil Nadu. At same time, it is the smallest territories in our Tamil Nadu. Okay. So Chennai is developed during the British period. So British given the importance not only the Chennai, Mumbai, then Calcutta. So this is the three important presidency for during the British period. In this class, we are going to discuss about municipalities and corporation. So what is municipalities and corporation? So government for ruling, they divided different provinces. For example, district, taluk, then block, municipalities, municipal corporation, village, ward. So like they divided different administration for ruling the government. Okay. So like one of the division is municipalities and municipal corporation. So what is municipalities? If you take Namakkal. So Namakkal is one of the municipalities, more than 10 lakh people. Okay. That area is called as municipalities. And municipal corporation. For example, Chennai, Coimbatore, Salem, Tiruchi. So these are examples for the municipal corporation. There are 14 municipal corporation in our Tamil Nadu. Okay. So there are 38 districts in our Tamil Nadu. Among that, 14 municipal corporation in our Tamil Nadu. Okay. So municipalities and municipal corporation given the importance during the British period. So during British period, for giving this importance, they divided three passes. Okay. They divided three passes. The first passes. First passes in the year 1688 to 1882. Next one is second passes. So second passes are during the period 1888 to 1920. And next one, the third passes 1920 to 1950. So during the British period, they divided three passes. First passes, the period is 1688 to 1882. And second passes, 1888 to 1920. And third passes, 1920 to 1950. Okay. So municipal government is one of the important during the British period. They started the Madras Municipal Corporation. Okay. In that period, they started Madras Municipal Corporation mayor. So in that area, the municipal corporation, they called as mayor. They called as mayor. Okay. So it is responsible for started for Josiah Child. He is the one of the East India Company director. Okay. So who started this municipal corporation, Madras Municipal Corporation? Sir Josiah Child. He is the East India Company, British East India Company, one of the director. Okay. So the Charter Act, with the help of Charter Act 1793, they established municipal administration. And given they started Ayodhya, Bombay, then Kolkata. So most of the places they started the self-government. So this is during the first passes, Sir Josiah Child started the municipal corporation. Okay. And next one, the second passes. The second passes, the Charter Act. Okay. The second passes, the importance of Magna Carta. Lord Ruthven. So Lord Ruthven started the municipal corporation. So Lord Ruthven. So he is given the importance of start the municipal corporation. So he is called as father of municipal corporation in India. Okay. So Lord Ruthven is called father of municipal corporation in India because he only given the more importance to start the municipal corporation with the help of the Magna Carta. Okay. So that he is called as father of local self-government in our India. So local self-government. So what is local self-government? So local self government. So in our India, three tier of government: central government, state government, and local government. So central government, it is ruling by Prime Minister of India, and state government, it is ruling by Chief Minister, and local government, which is called local government, village, municipalities, municipal corporation. So it is called as local government. Okay. So our Mahatma Gandhi said, India not as a village. In village only India is available. So it is said by Mahatma Gandhi. So this local government, it is introduced by Lord Ripon. So he called as father of local government in India. Okay. So Lord Ripon given the importance of local government. So what is local government? So this we are connecting the action for the village panchayat. Every village has panchayat. Okay, president. Panchayat president. So then municipal president, ward member, municipality corporation. So this is all example for the local government. Okay, it is local government. So Lord Ripon, with the help of the Magna Carta, introduced the local government. So he called us father of local self-government in India. Okay. Next one is the third passage, 1920 to 1950. So third passage, 1920 to 1950. So the Government of India Act 1919 introduced the hierarchy. So Government Act in 1919, hierarchy means dual government. Okay. So British and India as well, they can rule the India. So it is Indian Government Act. Okay, India Government Act 1919 introduced the hierarchy, which means dual government. Both India and British can rule our country. Okay, so it is called as hierarchy. It was introduced in 1919. And the Government of India Act 1935 introduced provincial autonomy. So this provincial autonomy is given the importance of the local government. Okay, so during the period 1935, is given the importance of local government. And next one, we are going to discuss about administration of the presidency term. Administration. Okay. So next, we are going to discuss about administration. So this administration term. So administration, what is called administration? The ruling the area, the ruling is called as administration. Ruling is called as administration. So what is ruling? For example, one of the important for the village or country is sanitation, water supply, drainage, then electricity, road facilities. So these are basic needed for our people. So this is basic needed for our people. It is responsible for the local government. Okay, it is responsible for the local government. So local government getting the help from state government and central government. Okay, state government getting help from central government. So this is our basic need for the sanitation, then road facility, water supply, electricity. So these are important for the people. So local government is providing to the people. Okay, so it is the important for the administration. So this administration, it is three tiers of government. It is giving for the people: central government, state government, and local government. Okay, so three tier government giving the administration, giving the good government. Okay, good government to the people. Okay, so in this class we discuss about municipalities and municipal corporation. There are 14 municipal corporation in our Tamil Nadu. Okay, in our Tamil Nadu, the municipality, for example, Namakkal. Okay, so this small, less than 10 lakh population is called as municipalities. So municipality, municipal corporation. So administration, this is all you discussed in this class. Okay. Next, learn and write the following. The question is, explain creation of municipalities and municipal corporation. Next question is, discuss administration of the presidency terms. Okay. So read well. Thank you.